r/Credit created by Routine Reddit. What band has done more for you emotionally than any other? Soundgarden. R.I.P. Chris, he had the voice of an angel. I was surprised by how much his death affected me. First time I ever cried for someone I didn't know, messed me up that whole week. Then freaking Chester, just a couple months later. Played their music the rest of the summer at my store. On Chris's birthday no less. I really wonder if the two events were connected. They were good friends apparently. The Cure, for about 30 years now. Editor respond. I woke up this morning to see all the love and comments from people who also have been touched by The Cure, and it has made me so happy. The first Cure album I heard was Disintegration. I was 14, and within 30 seconds of listening to Plain Song, I knew I'd love their music forever. My favorite Cure album is Wish. I know, people gripe about Friday I'm in Love. But I love it too. And Simon? In the video? R.A.W.R. The Cure has been my soundtrack for almost all my most formative years, and certainly through a ton of life-changing events as an adult. If you're sad and miserable, there are songs. Deliriously happy and silly? Songs. Reflective? Angry? Lonely? Totally in love? You've got 40 years of music to match every possible emotion. I live in the absolute middle of nowhere, so didn't get to see the Hyde Park show this week. The closest showing was about 300 miles from me. I'm hoping it comes out on DVD. I did see The Cure in 2016 near Denver. It was a night I'll never forget. It really felt like being at a family reunion with 17,000 relatives. Everyone was so happy and friendly, and covered the gamut from baby goths to men in dockers. Best night of my life. Disintegration changed my life. Absolutely agree. I remember the first time I heard it. In my life there was a time before the opening chimes of Plain Song, and there is the time after it. Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. One of my dad's favorites became one of mine when I was young. I can just sit and listen and you can just feel something in Tom's voice. Some of their songs are still, I think, some of the best rock songs ever made. American Girl gets you feeling away like no other song. Yes, I had to scroll way too far for this. Wild Flowers at the top of the list. Same here, it's one of my favorite albums. Creedence Clearwater Revival. Heck yeah. What a band. So much emotion. Such talent. They cover the whole spectrum of feelings. John Fogerty was the only talented one emo. The rest of them rode his coattails big time. Are you John Fogerty? Beat me to it, haha. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe for daily Reddit videos. Modest Mouse. Talking crap about a pretty sunset and ocean breathe salty basically hooked me out of the existential sadness mode that I was in for about a year. I made a comment elsewhere, but I'm gonna respond to you. Since I'm late to the party, Isaac Brock was such a freaking great lyricist. He may not be the best storytelling songwriter ever, but he has so many one-liners slash short passages that are incredible. The rest of the music helps paint the picture and fill it all out. The vocals, the music, and the lyrics all come together in a perfect mix. So many great individual parts on various songs too. No matter how many times I listen to them, I always find myself almost forgetting about great songs on various albums, because everything up through Good News is just so freaking good. So many times, when I'm feeling particularly down, I find myself singing Different City in my head. People don't give We Were Dead before the ship even sank, and no one's first, and you're next enough credit. Just listen to the lyrics of both albums. Absolute gold. I saw them at Brewery Omegang a few years back. They opened with King Rat and Whale Song, followed by Tiny Cities. Absolutely killed it. Still get chills thinking about it. Fleetwood Mac was there for me through the end of my first breakup. It was nasty and the worst time for me emotionally, and their music is still so relevant and powerful, and no artist or group could make me feel less alone than they did. I used to listen to them way more often. I don't now, because my music tastes have expanded over the past few years, but every time I do listen to them, it feels like home. Edit, wow. I wasn't expecting this to blow up overnight. Thank you, kind human, for my first silver. Edit 2, a gold 2. Thank you as well. I would love to converse more with people, but I posted this at around 1 AM my time and I have to work. It really is some of the most powerful music I've heard, and the stories of the songs being created on the album Rumors, with Stevie and Lindsay both contributing songs, written about each other, and all the cocaine and the sleeping around, all just contribute to it, and just how freaking enchanting Stevie Nicks is live. I went to a concert of them when I was 18, the year the band had gotten back together, knowing so little about the band, having heard very little, and God, if that wasn't the best concert I've been to. I'm not their biggest fan, but boy, Rumors is still one of the greatest albums I've ever listened to. I managed to see them live after years at the Wembley Stadium a couple of weeks ago, and it brought back so many great memories. The Strokes. The Strokes make me feel nostalgic about a time I can't even remember. Same for me. It seems like their songs are about a previous life I would like to have had. I feel this so hard. Their songs remind me of elementary middle school. Getting to see them in 2015 took me back to angst, happiness, sadness and teenage confusion. Love them. My high school marching band. My high school band director committed suicide in April. Absolutely heartbreaking. So many of us looked up to him as the best mentor that we ever had. Mine is in prison for minor related crimes. The day they told us about was one of the hardest days of my life. We all looked up to that guy, and overnight we found out he was a monster. It took me a couple of reads to realize minor related doesn't mean petty crimes. Same. Was confused thinking guy had speeding tickets and a bounce check. And then, a perfect circle edit. I'm completely blown away by the fandom here. I wasn't expecting this to find so many kindred spirits. Reading the comments has been wonderful. 13th Step got me through a really rough time in my life. Same here, man. The lyrics are so powerful. Little angel, go away. Come again some other day. The devil has my ear today. I'll never hear a word you say. Dude the Pet, and The Noose, and Three Libras Acoustic. And surprisingly, the new album had grown to be my favorite. Lots of bangers after a few playthroughs. I'm sorry for being so emo, but My Chemical Romance. I had a mild emo phase back in high school and their songs helped me so much through puberty. They have such a special place in my heart, and I can't just casually hear their songs anymore, because it gives me so many kinds of feelings. Mostly good but also very nostalgic, and they give me the shivers. Edit, holy crap guys, thank you for the awards. Back in high school I used to be read to filth for liking emo music, so it's great to know many others feel the same as I do. Thank you so much. Oh dude, I saw them live, and I'm so glad I did. They were playing and everyone was scream singing along. Song changed, within the first 3 chords I was crying. It was Cancer. So many people were crying. I couldn't tell you what other song they sang that night, to be honest. I still have all their CDs in my truck. 21 Pilots is pretty good. Their cover of Cancer is one of the first covers I actually like. I wish I saw them live. I vividly remember how my late sister introduced my brother and I to the Black Parade. Listening to Cancer always has me bawling. Linkin Park. They remind me of a time my dad cared about us. And a lot of other things. Edit. Thank you for the awards. Edit 2. I go to sleep, and I see so many soldiers still here after Chester left us. That's so great. I'm sorry I can't reply to everyone, but I did see at least 80 plus messages and I read them. It's make me so happy people still love the band and are out there support Mike's solo travels and everyone else's solo travels too. I'm sorry for those who had less the exceptional experiences in one way or another, and I'm happy you're still here. I wish you all the best within your future. Linkin Park has done, and still does a lot to me. I started listening to them since I was 5, and they were playing in the background, along with MCR, for years and years, and then Chester died, and he marked one of the worst years of my life. I did a lot of things that year and the one to come in terms of LP, and I met a lot of people. I also got way closer with Mike and the band. It still hurts a lot. The soldiers of Linkin Park will be there for each other. Stay strong, my friend.